皆さんこんにちは。 My name is Yuki. I'm Japanese and now I live in Japan. On December 22nd of this year, the Northern Hemisphere will reach the winter solstice. I'm glad that the daylight hours will be getting longer little by little from tomorrow. In Japan, there are ways to spend a winter solstice. Today,I would like to introduce how to spend it. I will explain in English first, and then I'll explain the same content in Japanese. Now, let's start with the English part. The winter solstice is the shortest day of the year, and this year's winter solstice is December 22nd. In Japan, it is also called Ichijō Raifuku Day, when the yin and yang change. Today, I would like to introduce the unique custom in Japan that are held on the day of the winter solstice. The first is yuzu yu. This is a bath with a fruit called yuzu. On the day of the winter solstice, we take this yuzu yu to warm our body. It started in Edo period. Public baths provided yuzu yu to attract customers on the day of the winter solstice. From Japanese puns, it is said that if you take yuzu yu at the winter solstice, you will not catch a cold all year round. The words toji, treat with hot water, and toji, winter solstice, and yuzu, flexibility, and yuzu, fruit, are similar. Besides, yuzu has a very nice aroma and has a relaxing effect. The vitamins contained in yuzu also have the effect of beautifying the skin. On the day of the winter solstice, we can take in yuzu yu in some hot springs or public baths. We can also buy yuzu at a nearby supermarket and enjoy it in the bath at home. If you don't have yuzu, it is recommended to enjoy it with bath salt with yuzu flavor. The second custom is eating pumpkin. There are no rules on how to eat or cook, and it is a very simple custom. Like yuzu yu, it is said that eating pumpkin at the winter solstice makes us not catch a cold. Pumpkin is a vegetable that harvested in the summer but can be preserved until the winter. And because it has no much nutrition, it has eaten as a variable winter food. For this reason, eating pumpkin at the winter solstice started. I don't know when this custom started, but pumpkins were introduced in Japan around the 16th century. So I think it started after the 16th century. The style of eating pumpkin is free. So we enjoy it as a boiled pumpkin, pumpkin soup, or pumpkin koroki. I like pumpkin soup and pumpkin salad. Yuzu yu and pumpkin are common people's customs, so they have no religious meaning. However, on the day of the winter solstice festivals are held at many shrines in Japan. One of the most famous festivals is Anahachimangu Shrine Festival in Waseda, Tokyo. At Anahachimangu Shrine, Ichijō Raifuku amulets and bells will be given from the day of the winter solstice to the day of the Setsubun on February 3rd. On the day of the winter solstice, many people line up to buy amulets and bells every year. I will buy yuzu and pumpkin for this year's winter solstice too. Are there any special customs for the winter solstice in your city? please let me in the comment. That's all. Then I will switch to the Japanese part. 冬至は1年のうちで日照時間が一番短い日で、今年は12月22日が冬至です。日本では陰が極まった後に陽に変わる一陽来復の日とも言われています。そんな冬至の日に行う日本独自の風習を今日は紹介したいと思います。一つ目がゆず湯です。これはゆずという果物を入れたお風呂のことです。冬至の日はこのゆず湯に入って体を温めます。江戸時代、銭湯で冬至の日に客寄せのためにゆず湯を提供したことが始まりだと言われています。日本語の語呂合わせから、冬至にゆず湯に入ると、一年中風邪をひかないと言われています。日本語の湯で治療する冬至と冬至。物事がうまく運ぶという意味のゆずとゆずという言葉が似ています。その他にも、ゆずはとてもいい香りでリラックス効果があります。ゆずに含まれるビタミンは美肌の効果もあります。冬至の日には温泉や銭湯でもゆず湯に入れることが多いです。近くのスーパーでゆずを買って家のお風呂で楽しむこともできます。ゆずがなければ入浴剤で楽しむのもおすすめです。二つ目の風習はかぼちゃを食べるというものです。食べ方や料理に決まりはなく、とっても単純な風習です。ゆず湯と同じように、冬至にかぼちゃを食べると、風邪をひかないと言われています。かぼちゃは夏に収穫されますが、冬まで保存ができる野菜です。そして、とても多くの栄養があるので、冬の貴重な食べ物として食べられていました。こうした理由で、冬至にかぼちゃを食べるようになったと言われています。いつこの風習が始まったのかはわかりませんが、日本にかぼちゃが伝わったのは16世紀頃と言われているので、16世紀以降だと思います。煮物にしたり、スープ、コロッケなど食べ方は自由です。私はかぼちゃスープやかぼちゃサラダが好きです。今日紹介したゆず湯とかぼちゃは庶民の風習なので、宗教的な意味はありません。しかし、冬至の日は日本各地の神社で冬至祭が行われることもあります。最も有名な冬至祭の一つは、東京の早稲田にある穴八幡宮という神社の冬至祭です。穴八幡宮では冬至の日から2月3日の節分の日まで一陽来復のお守りやお札が授与されます。冬至には毎年多くの人がお守りやお札を求めて並んでいます。私は今年も柚子とかぼちゃを買って冬至を迎えたいと思います。皆さんの町では冬至に食べる 食べ物や特別な風習はありますか？よかったらコメント欄で教えてくださいね。 That's all! Good to enjoy it! Thank you for watching! Please thumbs up and subscribe to my channel! じゃあまたねー。